Got my RAM installed, 32 gigabytes of 3600 megahertz DDR4. Pretty satisfied with that, and I don't expect any big performance gains in this game, but I do in future in other stuff I play, like Cyberpunk 2077, and not exactly big performance gains, but you know, so noticeable. Stream manager open on my tablet and we'll be ready to roll. And today I will be on a Discord channel with some friends from work and other places, just kind of hang out chatting with them. So instead of my normal stream of consciousness, it'll probably just be bullshitting with them about who knows what. We were just recently disparaging the Battle of Alamo and maybe 9/11. But anyways, so let me get Discord turned back on. Hello, hello. I'm back.
Welcome back.
All right. I'll go ahead and turn the stream on here. So earlier, I was trying to create this character, Sean, and I picked the wrong class. But this one's name is Thick, or Thick.
Thick.
T apostrophe H I K. And he is, as described.
Call him what the humans call.
Thick. But then we got a Farvus Grundle here. He's also a thick boy.
Goblin. No.
This was my main way back in the day, Randy Razzle Dazzle. Smuggler.
Okay, I need to log off and go get my... I'm getting the COVID antibody test.
Oh, did you get the vid?
The what?
The Rona?
No, I just want to know if I had it, or I'm immune, or if I'm immune. It's only $10, so I was like, whatever. Might as well.
Where do you get that kind of thing?
LabCorp.
Okay.
Hey, Muffins, are you there? Can someone ping Muffins? My game is stuck.
How many packets do you want me to hit him with?
Give him as many as you can.
Oh man, the day we found out about how to do that in comm school when I was in the Marines, like we figured out how to like basically DDoS each other on the schoolhouse network.
I pinged him.
It was great.
I guess he's gone.
Alright, I'm gonna do some of the space combat stuff, Trev.
I've never actually done the combat other than killing shit while doing quests.
It's fairly fun.
Invite.
It's not two person. Now, the Starfighter stuff is, but I haven't done Galactic Starfighter.
What?
Galactic Starfighter is like...
No, the other one. The single player.
It's PvP. What? But the rail shooter one is a single player.
Context. Activities. Talk about war zones? Starfighter?
No. Starfighter.
What is that? I have a fleet? I have ships? What? I wonder if I had ships for.
I
see how bad I am flying shit.
If you're doing the rail shooter one, if you're not doing Starfighter, there's not necessarily a bad. Like, you can run into stuff, but it's pretty easy to move around. And these function as dailies. So, as far as dailies go, they're not terrible. They're a nice change from the regular gameplay.
Ow, fuck me.
Especially because they really have a feeling of, like, the space battles in the movies. At least from Jedi and Revenge of the Sith. Not the the shitty space battles from Rise of Skywalker.
I like Rogue
Squadron. Oh, Rogue One?
The first one? The OG one?
Yes. I know what you're talking about.
That was fun. I used to kill bitches all the time. I also did, like, what is it? Battlefront 2 had that space combat as well, right? First, the very first one.
The old one, yeah, it has.
Yeah. Oh my god, queue's long. Not a lot of people play this game. My Jawa, we shall vanquish our enemies. My Jawa is so cool.
Okay, sorry, I'm back. I kept getting interrupted.
Hey, dude.
Welcome. Oh, I was gonna say welcome back.
Muffins, I have a challenge for you.
So what's going on?
I want you to go to the Alamo carrying a sandwich board that says Mexico 1 ROT 0.
Okay.
It's gonna be like that scene in the third Die Hard. Where, like, we just see how long you last. What say you? Are we accepting silence as consent here?
Oh, you're talking. Sorry. No.
Okay.
What are you talking about, Jack? You're just going off on random shit.
Oh, it just said host left.
I was like, so. You stopped responding and then my game froze and I was like, alright, well, I don't know what's going on, so I had to close out.
No, fuck, sorry, I kept fucking interrupted. I had to run around and, like, occasionally run back to my computer to play out a turn, but...
You're all good.
Sit down. Do we want to restart, or...?
Yeah, probably have to restart. I doubt it saved the campaign, and if it did, we'll start that game. We'll just start up where it left off.
What am I supposed to do here? Just kill? Team Deathmatch? Alright, kill.
So, Muffins, is your confused silence acceptance of this mission or confusion?
He probably didn't hear you.
And he responded.
Can he hear us now?
I can hear you.
I'd say he'd probably be shot 37 times before he could actually get out of his car, but...
It's an odd specific number.
That's just because he lives in Texas. That has nothing to do with the sign or the mission.
That's just the risk you take.
Listen, when you're out there telling the truth about the world, sometimes you get shot 37 times for pissing off Texans.
Basically. Well, we're responding to, like, you know, the call for a shooting, the police don't bring guns, they bring mops, because they know by the time they get there, the situation's already resolved.
It's just a wet vac. Like, at what caliber? Okay, yeah, we'll bring two.
Alright, yeah, we're gonna have to start with one. I didn't save the campaign.
This shit's fucking hard.
I have never done the Starfighter.
So should I prioritize fighting dwarves, or...?
Be careful, those dwarves like to dig a hole.
If you can take the dwarves out early, that is really good, because late game dwarves are really overpowered. So, if you can do it, do so. If not, just focus on constantly being in fights with somebody.
Fuck me. The controls of this shit, bro.
It is a 10-year-old game, almost.
Holy fuck. I'm using a scout now.
Well, one of the ships is like a sniper.
Campaigns. Multiplayer. Resume as host. Aha, there we go. Did have an autosave. Load. Send you an invite.
This other bitch took my kill.
Alright, cool, so
we
didn't lose any progress.
Oh, dope, I just...
I could go straight for the Dwarven Capital, but... I feel like that might not be a great idea. I'm gonna have to look at the power balance.
Fortune favors the bold.
My one little goblin tribe.
And living that way, Alexander the Great conquered the known world. Or at least all the parts that he cared about.
He didn't conquer Texas. No one conquers Texas.
That's all I'm saying. He didn't conquer Texas. He's not that great. Didn't conquer the greatest country in the world.
You are from Texas, Muffins. So recently, I think my mom's bored because she's been doing all this shit during lockdown that, like, none of my sisters can figure out why she even cares about it. But she's doing, like, all this genealogy stuff. And she figured out that we are all related to some dude who, like, palled around with Daniel Boone and all, before he went off to die at the Alamo. And, it's just interesting stuff, but she's been chronicling it all, and like she gets on Ancestry.com, finds all the records, and then like puts it into a narrative. Her prose is okay, nothing great, but it's just like I'm waiting for the call where she's like, yeah, I'm trying to get somebody to make a movie out of this. Do you know how to do that? Me and all my sisters are just like, what the fuck? Is this real life?
All I know is one half of my family came over with the pilgrims, the other half, like, super French. Came over after World
War. Exactly how French?
Yeah.
Did they just sit around brooding, smoking, and complaining about not having enough croissant?
Yeah.
Like, you would think that they own stock in Philip Morris. Like, no. Every time I open one of these, I get 30 cents. I gotta keep going.
Bruh. This shit's actually fucking hard.
Orc dialogue.
Daka daka.
Pay you.
Wah.
Oh, they're paying me 300 gold to accept a non-aggression pact?
Orcs are doing this.
I don't know.
This...
Do orcs ally with each other, or they just beat the living shit out of each other?
I would just assume that orcs are shifty bastards and you should never trust them.
Right.
How do you do missiles? This doesn't really tell you shit about the game.
Right click does missiles.
Right click doesn't do shit.
Sometimes it does.
Have you guys seen Jimmy John's new slogan?
I'm sorry?
One of my friends just texted me. She sent me a message and a picture. She goes, I got Jimmy John's. What's their new slogan? Because sandwich. She shows the bag. It's
wow.
Just the Jimmy John's slogan, and the slogan underneath it is because sandwich.
Is Jimmy John's being run by orcs now?
Sam, like when the marketing team fucking gives up. Why should people buy our sandwiches? Because sandwich.
It's, this is halfway. Oh my fucking lord.
Alright.
The situation. This is not a fun experience.
How do I see? Is fightiness tied to the army or like your global?
They changed it so now it's your entire army. So, like, if you look up at the top,
yeah.
You'll see that bar. Yeah. And I'm trying to understand it too now because they've definitely changed the mechanics. It used to be per army, but now I think it's your total fightiness of all of your groups.
So, at the moment, I have a passive gain of 1 by doing nothing.
Yeah.
So I'm just sitting here just recruiting shit tons.
So I right click and it just locks on. That's all it does. And I stay locked on and it just doesn't do anything. Push it again,
yeah.
And it unlocks.
Are you sure it's not shooting a missile when it locks on?
Nope, because I'm not shooting anything at all.
Well,
I'm just hitting the right trigger and nothing's coming out.
When it locks on, click the left click. Or Google.
Good to see a pretty face. So long as I'm not just a pretty face.
The circumstances have to be unpleasant. The Eagles men are using the war as a cover for local
activities. Balmora
is their training ground.
Cell members instruct and arm new terrorists
here. Fresh soldiers. I never did that, but the real shooters. It's a
vital part of the.
So
I've had
no real shooter option.
I've had this computer for literally years, and I never realized there was this little until like the other day when I nearly fell out of my ass in it. That there's this like little switch in the front. That like releases a lock and allows it to lean back.
Is there more I should know?
It had gotten flipped somehow, and I sat down, just like you know, flipped.
That's
ass
like
overhead.
An every 2 days occasion for me.
Is it war zones or is it arenas?
What you do is, Trav, you go into your ship. Can you see my screen? Go to my stream. I'm either on Twitch or on the server.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm on my bridge, right? You get your space missions over here from some little console that has a little mission icon over it. You accept them. And then you come over here, you open up the map, and then it'll be... I'm not sure where it is. It's not Hutta. It'll appear like Hutta, even though this isn't the mission, because I already did my dailies. But they'll appear here after you accept them.
So I'm very confused. Red Eye offered me this non-aggression pact, and it said their power rating was like 3 times mine, but now looking at the bar, the balance of power is way in my favor.
You could violently stomp these gobos into the ground. They're not powerful, so you can take it if you want to kind of like vassalize them or something like that, or if you just want to crush them and take their land, you can do both. So yeah, it's kind of up to you.
I did. I took it, and I'm probably going to turn on them as soon as my army's full. But yes. I didn't understand that power rating thing. It said, like, yeah, I don't know.
So you took a non-aggression pact with the Red Eyes.
Right.
Alright, let me counter offer. I demand money. I demand 600 gold.
Counter offer, you give me the lunch money, and I beat you up anyways.
They rejected my offer. Alright, fine. Die like the rest of them. Okay.
The other thing, Trav, is that you can upgrade all of your, like, your shields, your guns, your missiles, all kinds of shit on your ship.
I saw that, I was like, what's the point of doing that?
It's for the stuff. I don't...
Real quick, toss a beer in the fridge.
I do not think it applies to the Starfighter stuff, because I'd never done Starfighter.
But... Starfighter, I was using other ships.
Right. Starfighters.
Yeah.
So, when you upgrade your ship, you'll do... Because, like, eventually you'll start doing those missions, and they will just fuck you up. And you won't be able to finish the real shooters.
So, I need to find a... Good to see the starship upgrade. Up this bombed out crater.
It's on the Imperial Fleet. Conquest Consolidation Corps. It's over in the Galactic Goods Market. The ones who seal the deal. Don't suppose you're aware of the situation here on
Balmora? I've been briefed, but I could use more details.
It's war, bloody and limitless. The Empire invaded Balmora in the last war, but we've been spinning our wheels in the mud ever since. Supplies or fighters think they combat training?
Yeah, it's like Galactic Market or something like that.
Okay, so Galactic Trade Market, got it.
How do you expect to succeed where the Imperial Army has failed?
We are the army too. Other soldiers just don't have the capability to handle our kind of specialized missions. The Balmoran government in exile, backed by Minister of Defense Vol Argen, is giving us fits. We're backing a strong faction of the resistance.
Okay. Research available. Planet, but if we break his allies here, is there a research line you would recommend?
What about the rest of the Balmoran government in exile?
I've never played your branch of work before, the one with military experience, and so he's the most vocal. Know what works best on them. I personally go Bigga and then into Big Bullies. That's why we need to take everything out. Then do we have the privilege of your support?
If the Empire requires it of me.
Spoken but like a true patriot. After that, I kind of start to my lose second in command, Lieutenant
Davril. Yeah, I just went like straight through Gabby Gabbo's Gabba Crackdown. You'll find him in Sobrick. He'll go pulling teeth and get some extra money. That'll work.
Trav, once you and I are done with these two characters, we should. One of us rock one Sith class and the other one the other. And just like team rocket the shit out of it.
Protect the world from devastation.
I don't
That's
know
right,
the,
goblins have camps.
I don't know the whole Team Rocket thing. All I know is that something where trouble will make it double.
Prepare for trouble and make it double.
Double make up.
That's right.
To protect the world from devastation, unite all people within our nation.
To denounce the evil of truth and love. To extend our reach to the stars above.
James!
Oh,
Team Rocket's blessing off at the speed of light. Surrender now, we'll prepare to fight. Meow, that's right.
You guys are fucking
God,
nuts.
It's only been like 25 years since I heard that.
You were two?
Yeah.
Hmm?
Nah, I'm of course hyperbole, but...
It's been like 20 years since I've heard that? Jack's like, you were two? I'm like, come on, think. Sean's 22.
Yeah, he's at 25.
Yeah, I said 25.
Oh.
It has been 25 years since I heard it.
Has it been out for that long?
Damn near.
Pokemon's still going, too.
Oh, yeah.
God, did you guys see the thing I posted in SFW about...
The girl with the mask?
No. If you could balance on your dick and spin, how long would it take before, like, dudes were having Beyblade-like battles by spinning on their dicks?
There's 23 of Pokemon. If you do the math right, makes sense. One a year. It came out in 97.
So 23 years. It's been 23 years since I first heard that. But yeah, what do you think? Beyblade dick balance battles?
I'd be game.
Think about the core strength required for that. You're basically planking while balancing on your way.
That's the part of your body that would have to be strong to do that, Jack? Your core?
We're making the assumption that you can have and maintain an erection hard enough to balance on it.
So we're just giving that one away. That's strong enough.
That's, yes.
You're worried they're doing enough sit-ups.
That's the plot armor for this idea.
You train for competitions and, you know, it's like you're little Billy, not really into it, but your dad really wants to live out his sports dreams through you. So he's like, you do your dick-ups today, son. Come on.
Cock push-ups.
1, 2, 3.
Well, what have we here? Let me take a look at you. You're one of Keeper's boys, eh? I'm glad he finally sent someone. Pity it took a disaster to get headquarters attention.
You're talking about the attack on Dorman Cars.
Disaster's the only word for it. Thousands dead, a Dark Council member assassinated. Hard to believe the Empire's come to this. But here, I'm being a poor host. Have a drink. Settle in after your trip. This shop doesn't look like much, but it's secure.
Secure or not, it is an odd place to work from.
The shopfront's a necessary deception. The Republic and the terrorists have people everywhere. Rather than calling secret informants into a military base, I speak to them here, and no one's the wiser. These terrorists you're after, they've been a thorn in my side for a long while. They're worse than the Republic.
This guy sounds like a 19th century industrialist. Like, these terrorists, striking my unionization.
How'd you say that?
Familiarity. The terrorists know Balmora. The Republic doesn't, at least not as well. This terror cell is homegrown, made up of Balmorans unhappy with the Empire's rule. I suspect the Republic tacitly supports the terrorists with their common enemy. So we do our best to cope with the bombings and sabotage.
Bully!
I'm listening. Continue.
The governor makes an example of a few dozen Balmorans after each attack, but it doesn't have much of an effect. Meanwhile, I've been studying the terror cell structure, and there's good news. If we can take out the local leader, the cell should fall apart.
What do we know about this person?
The terrorists call the man in charge Grey Star. He runs the cell, gives the orders, and knows all the secrets. They claim Grey Star used to work with the Eagle, but who can be sure? Only the high-ranking cell members know Grey Star's identity.
It's a complication, but there's opportunity there.
I have a mole inside the terrorist cell already. He's a good lad. No cipher, though. He can bring you in. You'd have the opportunity to impress the terrorists, win their trust.
And gain access to their leader.
Precisely. Grey Star will be ours. Sanju Pine, my operative, can introduce you to the terrorist recruiters at the Troida Military Workshop outside the safe zone. But be careful how you present yourself. If the terrorists suspect you're Imperial, you'll lose Grey Star. And your lives.
So this dude that I was talking to, for no apparent reason, like, they decide his voice actor should sound like a 19th century industrialist. Like, he's terrorists. I say, he's terrorists. Bully!
Like, well, the mind will survive and never walk again.
Hey, Jack.
What's up?
You said when we finish, start Sith characters, right?
Yeah.
What Sith? Sith warriors or Sith inquisitors?
We should one do one and the other do the other.
Well, I mean, under the Sith warriors, you have like Sith marauder and Sith juggernauts, but then under Sith inquisitors, you have Sith sorcerers and Sith assassins.
Right. One should do one and then the other. That way we're not both playing the same storyline.
Is it the same storyline depending?
It's the same storyline, you just get to pick your class. I don't think the storylines diverge based on class. Like, subclass, I mean.
So what are you?
I am currently a sniper, which is a subclass of agent, I believe.
Yes.
I apparently can't do a trade agreement with these guys, which is very interesting. But I could confederate all of them if I wanted to.
Who are you playing as, Sean?
The orcs.
Orcs have trade agreements?
Mm-hmm.
Is it just bring more red paint or we'll kill you?
I mean, effectively. Trade is a loose word. It's kind of like how the mafia trades protection. And
trade, extortion, it's all semantics. Potato, potato.
I mean, to be fair, my income is like, in-game called extortion.
Extorted income.
Yeah.
It is. That's really funny. I didn't realize that.
What plan are you on now, Jack?
Balmoral.
I think I went there. Maybe.
Oh, I obtained a province.
I don't know what's going on here, but these dudes look like they're getting ready to force these people to jump.
Looks like it. Push them off. Push them off.
I can't.
Can't or won't?
It's definitely can't. Oh. I would totally do it if I could.
I mean, I think you're just not trying hard enough. It's a matter of willpower, and you obviously could not have enough of it.
No fucking way. Are the Skaven already a problem?
Are they running around?
Ratty boys. Oh.
There's one orc encampment south of me that's just ruins now, and I don't know who would go attack that particular settlement and turn it into ruins besides the fucking Skaven, because they can live in ruins.
Oh, I see it.
You don't want to underestimate
the
Ratty
Boys. That's not like a casual encampment. Like, that's a pretty key one.
Well, it's my hero is indeed an orc shaman.
I love how the dwarves, without any interaction with me, are violently hostile towards me. Negative 189 attitude.
Could they possibly have mistaken you for a goblin?
I think possibly. Considering, like, a third of my army is made of goblins.
Oh!
Yeah.
I wish, and there probably is, because... Well,
wow, don't know how I managed that.
There needs to be a mod for the, whatever the good guys are in that game, or the good aligned people, to have a hero that's called Goblin Slayer. And he is just, like, ridiculously OP against goblins and nothing else.
Where are the goblins?
I infiltrated the dwarf settlement. I don't know how my orc shaman did that. Just like, yeah, I'm a dwarf. Her.
Stick your face in the Duergar's grundle. Elves, don't quit!
Man, I love Zach, I really do, but this whole thing for his wedding has been driving me absolutely fucking crazy.
Is he still getting married, or isn't he?
I think he is, but they're doing it like... They keep doing this thing where, like, alright, we're gonna make plans, and then everybody agrees on something, and they're like, yeah, that doesn't work, and then we go with something entirely different anyway that no one voted on. It's like, why do we keep doing these deliberations?
So,
just tell us what to do.
So how long do you know this chick?
I have no idea. Not I think a couple of years, but they weren't dating that whole time, and like, it's a whole fucking
thing. So
I don't think they should be doing the wedding right now, regardless. I think during the pandemic, with all the shit going on, and there's no rush to get married, I don't think they should be doing the wedding, period.
Maybe, is she, like, super religious? Will she,
maybe.
Will she not, indulge in certain activities because they're not married?
I'm gonna go, I don't know, but I'm gonna go with hard guess here. No, I don't think that's the case.
So not that there's anything wrong with that.
And it's not even like a, I don't want them getting married kind of thing. It's just like, it's mid-COVID, we keep, like, having to make adjustments for it. It's gonna be in, like, a couple months, and, like, I don't think anything's gonna be better. Because, like, when we first planned this, it was gonna be like, oh, COVID will totally be better by then. And now we're, like, you know, balls deep in COVID, and it's not a thing. It's not getting any better. It's like, we need to put this off a little more.
So the leveling in this game is significantly faster now than it was back in the day, because they have so much extra content, it's increased the level cap so much that they made leveling ridiculously easy, just so to get you to the new content. Used to be this big multifaceted grind fest where you have to train your abilities, you had to go find a class trainer, and then you had to buy them off of them for significant amounts of money. And now it's just like, oh yeah, they're all free, and we're going to give you quadruple XP all the time.
Oh well. I will just have to raid everyone.
We'll cut a swath through the mountains to connect our tribes.
Well, here I go kill it again.
Well, the next people I'd have to kill to get to you would be these fucking super powerful dwarves up north of me, so I'm not super.
Yeah, we've. There's dwarves north of you and a different faction of dwarves south of me. It's kind of. It's two layers of dwarves sandwiched between our orcs.
Now, when you say sandwich,
I mean directly sandwiched. I'm direct northeast, direct south, and in between us is two factions of dwarves.
Oh yeah, your orc is the one that's possessed.
I'm possessed?
The crown is like possessing him basically, and like telling him all kinds of dark magics and secrets and shit. He's like,
interesting. Oh.
Could you imagine you're like this demi-lich that's trapped in a crown, and you get put on by this like orc with maybe 12 IQ? And you have to be like, look. I can help you to the big dead, and he'd be like, yeah, big dead, and then that's how you have to navigate the situation.
Feel the power! Yep, looks like all the dwarves are just frothing at the mouth, just like goblins towards me.
This better involve fighting. The orcs are such a fun race to play.
Always love the orcs in the old Warcraft games. You click on them enough, they go, "Quit poking me!" Yeah, I have no idea how to get this portion of the map I was supposed to go to.
What are these ratty boys doing? Oh fuck.
Are they engaging you?
They are.
Are they strong?
Kinda. It's all goblins though.
You might be able to take it. If you want to fight it out, you can. I don't mind. I wouldn't auto-resolve that.
No, you think I should fight it out?
I think you should fight it.
Can I take it back?
I don't think you can. Oh no.
Well.
Let's see. You won! Oh no. You won though.
Eat so. The captives!
Meat's back on the menu, boys!
Oh no. Definitely don't release enemy warlord. Definitely kill.
The way I always go with that is I either behead them or I confederate them. Like, you will either become part of my army or I will just wipe you out entirely.
If you eat them, in a way, like circle of life kind of way, or if they're becoming part of your army?
I mean, yes, a very specific part of my army, yes.
I can incorporate my hero now. Get in there!
I'm about to have trolls. That's nice. I've got a motherfucking troll!
Are you sure it's not just a really big goblin?
Can I not
incorporate the shaman into my army?
How many units do you have in your army already? 13?
It's not a full stack. Every time I right click, it like tries to like perform actions as if it was an enemy board.
So yeah, whenever you click in, it'll be like, oh hey, do you want them to join and do this? Like, because they have multiple abilities they can do. Like, I think the one that this one can do is called Scavin?
Scouting, yeah.
Scouting, yeah. So yeah, you should probably put him, yeah, there you go.
Oh. That was not how I expected that to work, okay.
It applies a general effect to the whole army. Mine's a scavenger, and it gives me more money for bullshit. Also, they can learn spells, which is really nice.
Hmm.
off the fact that all orcs want to fight for the best tribe, so if you can prove you're the best tribe and you're stronger, they'll just join yours. They're just like, yeah, sure. Sounds good to me, homie.
Well, I won, but I probably would have been in better shape had I not been in a march stance.
Yeah.
I was like, I want to get there, I want to get there, and then I was like, oh shit, he's got a full stack.
That full stack looms.
It was all goblins, too. Gem gobbos. Throw rocks and stones at us.
I actually don't want to upgrade either of those yet.
No! That was the staff of the Archmage of blah 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 gave to me! I'll kill you!
I'm helping, I'm helping!
Then she gets stabbed in the gut.
Ah! Shriek, shriek, shriek.
It is the goddamn Skaven.
Ah!
Look at him, he's right there with his fucking rat hands.
I hear rats make good meat.
What are your abilities? Do you have an assassinate ability? Yes, you do have an assassinate ability. I'm gonna murder this rat. I wanna get you up here because I wanna investigate Black Iron Mine, because I believe those dwarves are up to no good. And I'm already at war with them somehow.
Probably.
I don't remember calling battle with them, or encountering battle with them, but oh, they are fat. They are thick. Alright, this is gonna be hard.
Yup.
It's gonna be real hard.
That might be a two army fight right there.
Yeah, it's going to be.
I am lost as fuck on this planet.
Not all who wander are lost, but
no,
I sure as fuck am.
I was gonna say, nope, definitely lost.
You wanna go, Ratty Boy?
Yeah, that Ratty Boy just attempted something on my guy.
It's you and me, Tiny!
So the orcs above me just got their ass handed to them? They walked up.
Alright! Thank you for opening the account. We're just gonna move this over here, transfer this money, and stuff.
Oh, you've got someone crawling up on you there, man. Look at them.
Who are you? Oh, I'm
it's
dead.
The vampires. You probably can take them, but be careful.
All right. We're not a. Well. No.
I wouldn't go aggress them. I'm just saying, if they attack you, you don't have to be too worried. Your units are stronger and with better armor.
The city. Oof. Oof.
Instead of taking the city, you could drop into a raid camp, recover your units a little bit, steal some money from them.
That's huge. Go in camp, get some recover.
Steal some money. They've only got 33 approval, they're losing 8 a turn. They're gonna fucking go into rebellion.
Yes. Alright, who did lose? Ooh, a lot of my orc boys.
Yeah, they were the front lines. They got fucked. If you want to consolidate, you can consolidate your armies, but I don't know how you want to handle that.
So I'm definitely gonna need a new headset.
Oh.
The wire here in this is like the plastic insulation has like split. Rise and shine. And it's like a whole like snakeskin kind of just like peeling off.
No, that's what they do. It's the circle of life muffins. Just like keep doing that. It'll self heal. It might get a little hot if you were to touch it. shit, do I get down there?
I've had quite a few people declare war on me all of a sudden. Everyone is so testy, you murder a few of them and they get all murdery. Yeah, yeah, I assassinated that ratty boy. Take that, you dick.
Did I?
Ready for murdering.
The red eye's still around?
There's the encampment that you're stationed outside of.
Oh, right, That's right, I didn't attack him.
Which is a decision I agree with.
Yet. Didn't yeah. attack them.
Yeah.
Oh, sir. Are there any good headset models you guys would recommend?
How much do you want to spend?
I mean, not like ridiculously overpriced model, but
you have to define that.
$100
I don't know how much headsets are worth. Like, I would say, yeah,
wired
more than
wireless.
150 wired's fine.
I'm happy with my Razer Kraken Ultimate. And of course the Arctis Steel series is always good review as well. But hey, I'm gonna take a BRB.
Okay.
this one.
Oh yeah? Are you
I keep getting these advertisements for a game called A Kiss of War, and it's just like women in scantily clad clothes, like tied up and in various situations of danger that you then like save them from by tapping your screen. It's like, who the fuck is this for?
That's odd. So one of the streamers I follow solely because I don't follow him for this reason. I follow him because he runs a fairly decent cyberpunk game. But he works as like, I don't know if he's like a project manager or a product owner, but like he's in management for a adult video game company in Poland. Hmm. And he has, every now and then he talks about like the interviews he does, and it is... I mean, it's kind of strange. Like, he's not like some huge weird perv. You're lucky to get in BRB.
I got you those scramblers, didn't I? Come on, dude. You owe me. Maybe not big time, but you owe me.
When's the last time you did an operation for us?
What? Come on, we've been over this.
Graystar didn't send out a call for cowards, and neither did the Eagle. Do you think?
Hey, someone finally made it. It's great to meet you in person. This is the group I was telling you about. I think you'll get along with them real well. Better than I do, hopefully.
What are you talking about? We've never met.
What? I know... Sorry, I had to be vague during our holonet talks. My real name's Sanju Pan. Kemish, this is the guy who got in touch with me after the Eagles broadcast. Said he wanted to join us.
Uh-huh. Sanju says he fought the Imperials at Druckenwell. Says the Empire has a bounty on your head.
I didn't know you were at Druckenwell. We should talk.
Is all that real? You some ace killer looking to get the Empire off Balmora?
You think I don't live up to my reputation?
Maybe I do. Can you blame me? My name's Kemish. These people here, they follow Graystar, our founder. They've been spat on, starved, and punished by the Empire. Now you, you're not from Balmora. You haven't been through what they've been through. Makes me wonder how far I can trust you.
What makes you judge and jury around here?
See these cybernetics? Earned them after an Imperial soldier threw me to the torture droids because I looked threatening when I was 18.
Damn. Kemish, I never realized... You...
Sure, Sanju. So, yeah, I've earned respect around here. I've earned Graystar's trust. You've got a long way to go. Look, I don't have a problem finding people for sabotage and suicide runs. But real soldiers, they're harder to find. So, take a job, show you're useful, then we'll talk.
You got my attention. What's the job?
There's an abandoned factory not far from here. Used to make droids, but its defenses went haywire when the Empire took over. Place is swarming with rogue security units. It's also full of expensive equipment. Get inside, and there's something I want.
Name it, and it's yours.
The Okara Droid Factory produced shielded power cores for stealth droids. I want a case for my people. My people can convert the cores into explosives, plant them around an enemy base, and thanks to the stealth shielding, no one will know until it's too late.
As soon as you say the word, I can be on my way.
Let's be up front. This is a test. So if you fail, don't bother coming back. We'll just kill you.
Good luck. And be careful. The factory's a nasty place.
Back.
Welcome back.
Why step into cutscenes? I mean, you guys, so if anyone's, if anyone does stumble up on my stream and accidentally decides they like it, they aren't just listening to us talk about, you know,
random bullshit.
Desecrating 9/11 and all kinds of other shit. And this person, I don't know if it's the same person, but every time I stream for more than like an hour, somebody pops in and is like, "Hey, you wanna be famous? Buy followers here."
Yeah, no bots.
Is Trav still on? Trav.
God, they took forever to surrender. Like, I ran their lord off, like, 5 minutes ago.
Yeah, I was curious whether that the tides were not just entirely in your favor. You had won.
Do you think the moon, like, now there's, like, high tide, no tide, does that affect rivers as well?
I'd say yes. Depending on where the source of the river was.
So, like, the Hooch.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think it, because, like, when I go there in the morning, like, when I used to walk down there, like, there's, you know, days and times when it was significantly lower, and I always thought that was due to rainfall further upriver. But I wonder if it can be affected by the time, like, the tides.
The Hooch is a runoff river from the mountains. So, I'd say maybe, but not significant. Because, like, it'd be much more affected by the fact of, like, oh, there was heavy rainfall in the mountains.
Don't.
Yeah.
Oh, those little bastards. They tried.
This is my hiding spot, not yours.
Did it just skip my turn? How did that happen?
Do you require medical attention?
Never know.
Because you just fought. Oh, they attacked you, is what happened.
Oh, right.
They attacked you, then it went to the vampires, and it came back around to you again.
So in the process of making it quicker to level, this game, like all MMOs, you have a lot of just, like, pointless mobs between you and a lot of places on the map. And they used to make sense because you need to kill those guys to grind up both money and XP to, like, you know, buy stuff later. But since they basically made it so you don't have to, it's, you get tons of XP, and you really don't have to buy any of your skills now, it, like, they're pointless. There's no reason to have them, but they left them in there anyways. It's like they changed one mechanic without changing all the other things that are there because that mechanic was a certain way.
They're just giving you extra stuff to kill.
Now they're just annoying. And like side quests, you used to have to do a fuck ton of side quests. And now there's like completely no reason to do them other than you want to. But it used to be like, oh, well, I didn't get nearly enough from this, you know, mission that I was doing for a story, so I gotta do side quests on the world. Like, it's nice in some ways, but in others it's also like, this it almost feels easy, and I don't know how I feel about that.
These vampires over here are not that strong.
Is the sun out? Does that even matter?
I don't enter replenish units. But since they want to fuck with me,
I used to work with this guy who was like, he was apparently real into like the Anne Rice type vampires. But he also had some real funky ideas about them. Like, he's like, yeah, if you're being... And he would say this, like, kind of in a way that makes you think he might think that vampires are real. He's like, yeah, if you're being chased by a vampire, you can throw a... You can, like, throw a bunch of sand in the air, and, like, they're so obsessed with, like, counting things that they'll stop and count all the grains of sand, and that'll give you time. It's like, first of all, you know these aren't real. Second of all... In what world are your vampires, like, Rain Man autistic?
I'm not gonna lie, I did take that whole class on vampires, like, for college credit, and it was a whole thing. We had to read a whole book on vampires every week. It was fucking one of the hardest classes I ever took in college. And that is legitimate lore. Is that if you're being chased by a vampire, you can throw down, and they used to have different things, rice, sand, things like that, and vampires, for whatever reason in the lore, would get obsessed with having to count out each individual piece to help you get away. But that was not a universal thing, that was only in, like, certain lores. A really obscure set of lore than that.
There was another thing, he's like, yeah, if you tie a bunch of knots, they'll, like, you throw the sand in the air, and then you tie a bunch of knots, and that way, like, once they get done with the sand, they'll have to untie all the knots. Because, again, apparently, vampires are autistic. And not, like, just generally autistic, they're like Rain Man.
Yep. Muffins, can you, push this through?
Sorry. I'm sitting here on Amazon trying to look at new headsets, but Warhammer's not smart enough to let me use both my monitors, I guess.
Oh, Total War games are bad about that. It's not just Warhammer, it's any Total War game.
I absolutely destroyed the fucking dwarves.
supposed to be some fucking difference between the Razor Kraken Tournament Edition and the Ultimate Edition?
I think the Tournament Edition doesn't have light up your cups.
Once for tournaments.
I was gonna say, because it's like, the Ultimate Edition's twice as much, and it's like, hey, it has lights! I'm like, okay. I'm not paying you, like, a whole nother headset's worth for lights.
Wait, this should have been that much. I think I got it for like 125. Or 100, somewhere there. It wasn't like a huge... Maybe I got mine on sale, though. I don't know. It wasn't a huge difference between the Ultimate and the Tournament Edition when I was looking at them.
Yeah, no. Tournament's 80. Ultimate is 130.
Okay, that's about right. I do like superfluous light-up things, so...
This is true.
And me and Sean are gonna be first in line to to get the Razor credit card when it comes to America, just so we can have an RBG credit card.
Bet.
Well, sorry, not RBG, just light up. The second edition will be RBG.
I want the light up credit card. Not even gonna front.
I want a nice little like battery bar display instead of charge life. It's like money in your account.
Oh my god, that'd be great. Your credit limit.
Yeah.
Genuinely, that would be really, really cool.
And then the color of the card would be dependent upon your credit score. That, I don't know what kind of connectivity we'd need for this to, like, update on a daily basis, but I'm the kind of nerd who would buy this.
Got this like bacon flavor. I don't know. It's like plastic chewy thing that has like bacon piece in it. And he has no teeth, so he can't really chew it. So he just walks around with it in his mouth and cries because he doesn't know where to hide.
Thank the stars I reached you. Sorry about earlier. With Kenish there, I couldn't say it then. Station Chief Rattle told me you were from the Imperial Intelligence, so. I set things up as fast as I could. Anyway, Sanju Pai. Guess you know that.
What's the situation?
So, Kimish verified your background. Intelligence did its job. You're fine there. I'm doing my best to find out anything about the cell leader, Gray Star. Maybe you can learn more when Kimish trusts you.
Winning over Kimish is the top priority.
Right. Well, she's a fanatic, but she respects results. The more you impress her, the more she'll give. There's one other thing. Those power cores you're after, you know what Kimish plans to do with them, right? She's gonna attack Sobrek. She'll have some of the new recruits plant the bombs and run, hit the town and the Imperial base.
Don't interfere with this mission, Sanji.
I know. Just hear me out. I know a way to disable the power cores so Kimish won't suspect you. There's a machine in the factory that could do it. Run the sealed case through the machine, and the cores will fry. Kimish will see you didn't unlock it. She'll assume the cores went bad over the years.
It's a risk. But we could save a lot of people. I'm in.
Great. We'll send you the machine's coordinates. We can stop a lot of bloodshed. We'll see you when you get back to Troida, okay? Sanju out.
Kinda cute, isn't he? Kinda stupid, too. If he had money, he'd be perfect.
Don't let me stand in your way.
I never will. Anyway, let's find that machine. Or maybe not.
Okay, Lyra, you got the Rona? Didn't you go get a test for that or something?
Yeah, I just did.
Yeah, did they tell you?
No, it takes... They have to test your blood. It takes 3 days.
What is this, the Dark Ages?
Well, the rapid test takes 15 minutes. I had that, like, 2 weeks ago.
Is that the one where they poke your brain?
I mean, they stick a swab up your nose. It's not really poking your brain.
They get way up in there.
Not really.
So...
Maybe some people had done it wrong, but...
Well, so there's one where it's like, yeah, we stick a swab in your nose, and there's another one where, like, we are going for the big money and the Guinness Book of World Records. Like, they get way up in there.
I don't think that they... It's hard to tell how deep you are when you're applying it, a swab to somebody's nose. Especially when you're trying to, like, socially distance from them at the same time.
Way up in there, Morty!
So, like, I got the rapid test, and it came back negative within, like, 30 minutes. I got the result, and then I kept the PCR test, which is the more accurate one. I had an appointment for Sunday, and that one, you go through the drive-thru at CVS, and they actually, like, put through this little bag in the, like, slot, so there's, like, no contact at all, and there's a swab in there, and they call you and walk you.
Yeah.
That one, like, you can put up your nose as well, but, like, it's uncomfortable, but it's not, like, yeah, it's not swabbing your brain. I think people are just showing the worst cases. It's really easy.
Yeah, the only
this
thing
one,
I know about the CVS...
Antibody, okay. The antibody test is in your blood, so, like, the antibodies will be in blood, so they have to... I actually had to get blood draw. I had to go to LabCorp for that.
Does this mean that LabCorp are blood mages?
No.
They require blood to do their magic.
I mean, yeah, I guess if you think that science is magic, which I guess I do.
I mean, Arthur C. Clarke, a sufficiently advanced technology is indistinguishable from magic.
Boy, are we far from that.
So, I mean, are we?
Yes.
So, one thing that, let's see, I need to go back there. There was a, the guy who invented the table talk version of Cyberpunk, Mike Pondsmith, he was talking about how, you know, we're in the middle of a global pandemic, and yet him and this interviewer can sit down in front of their computers and talk to each other face to face. And even the gods of our ancient myths didn't have that sort of power. Like, they had to physically go to you. So in some ways, we have way outpaced the gods of our myths.
What? No, they didn't.
I'm pretty sure Paylor spoke directly to me.
I'll say there's lots of cases where the gods, like, appear in the sun, or, like, I saw his face in the water and he spoke to me, or I fucking saw a bird fly by and burst into flame. Oh, there's bushes on fire. There's lots of ways of talking to people that weren't walking up and being like, sup, G? Like...
It wasn't remote viewing, is what he's saying. It was you had to go to a thing and you couldn't just be, like, in your house and be like, oh, yeah, I've got this magic box that I can talk to people with. It was always, like, you had to go to the destination where they were, or they had to come to you and talk to you.
I mean, I guess I can't do that without a laptop either, but I guess they used, well, you know, means like a mirror or a bush that was on fire or a random bird or...
What are we talking about?
The guy's made his whole living on storytelling. I'm just going to side with him on this one, Sean. Not that it gets you or your reasons. I mean...
What the fuck's going on here?
We were having the discussion about the old saying, any significantly advanced enough to technology is indistinguishable from magic. And I'm like, yeah, but we're not close to that yet. And Doug's like, aren't we? And then made an argument that, like, we're able to basically have Skype calls, and gods in mythology couldn't make Skype calls. And I was like,
I look at a cell phone. All the shit that that does. It's... I don't know. I think since we're immersed in it, it's hard to tell exactly how magic it is. Or how much it would seem like magic. But I got another cutscene. So BRB.
Back already? Your friend's quicksand, you.
Told you he was good.
You tell me a lot of things, but I asked for the stealth droid power cores. If you don't have them, you're wasting my time.
Right here, Kamish. The full crate, all yours.
Huh. Looks like you actually made it to the factory. It'll take a minute to get this case open. Sanju, go fetch Pyther and a droid.
I think we've got it, Kamish. Crack the case open and let's see if our new friend did the job right.
Looks like everything's here. Except, what's this? The readouts say the power cores are fried. What did you do?
I went in there and got the case, like you asked.
You don't get to make excuses. Not to me, and definitely not now.
Kamish, come on. There are plenty of ways those things could have gone bad.
It is suspicious. But power cores are pretty fragile.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. Bad luck can happen to anyone. Once.
You said yourself that you need good people. Let me try again.
Fine. I'll give you one more shot, but you better make this work. You seen the caves in this valley? Dark and cramped, but they make a nice hiding place. Scanners bounce right off them.
Assume you're telling me this for a reason.
Greystar set up a training outpost in the caves a while back. Then the Empire started dropping gas bombs on the Republic. The outpost was poisoned. Toxin got into the soil. Turned good kids into drooling psychos. And the caves were overrun by our own people.
There's gotta be a way to flush the toxin out of your people. Restore their sanity.
Early on, maybe there was. It's way too late now. We're willing to cut our losses, but there's still data on the outpost computers. I want it transmitted out and the system's destroyed.
Sanju, get to high ground outside of town. You can pick up the signal with the booster box.
Is all that clear? The toxin victims will be after you, but get that data wiped or we're finished.
I know what I'm doing. I'll make it through the caves.
Now get out of here. I've got to figure out what we're going to do without those power cores.
I'm back.
Welcome back.
Hey Trav, where are the buttons to strafe?
Default Q and E.
Q and E? Okay. Yeah. What? What did I do?
They're done.
Oh, I'm accidentally in. Okay.
Yeah, so I removed the camera look, like the camera turn, from those buttons, WASD area. So now I just turn my camera with my mouse, because I'm normal use of that. So Q and E actually do nothing right now.
Why does it say I don't have any friends on, if you're on?
I'm on.
It says we aren't friends, Trav.
I see you. Did you set me as a friend?
Pretty sure I did.
Oh, can you right-click my name and add friend?
Can you send that again? Oh, there you are. It's, No, I can't.
Where, like, which one are you on?
Balmora.
I shall meet you there. Is there no, like, add friend where you can type my name out?
There is... There you are. Add to friends list. Well, bam.
How's your war against the dwarves going? Oh, you took Black Iron Mine. Damn.
I did.
That's weird. It still says zero in friends. Like, on the social tab. It says, but when I open it, it says one friend online. Weird.
Oh, whenever I open my social tabs, it says you have no friends.
No.
Does it not see Sean as...
I'm your friend.
Nick, so there you are.
Damn, boy.
I like how Grimgore just sits here, like, waving his axe around.
Yeah, right.
It was an axe, right? Let me zoom in. Yeah. It's either an axe or a hammer. Ugh, Averlorn. Played a Dark Elf campaign, and Averlorn, the High Elves, were just fucking a nightmare the whole time.
They really are.
Bard, where's the music?
I'm currently flying a ship, so... not here.
What is this little boy doing?
They've got a scout. If you had someone with Assassinate or Wound, I would get them on that.
What's this little boy doing?
That is the third fucking Skaven scout I've had to kill so far. They need to just give the fuck up on this. They're not gonna scout my land. Everyone they send out here, I'm gonna fucking kill.
Maybe they're,
Chaos time.
Maybe they're going with the Hail Hydra.
Hail Hydra.
Method of this. You kill one, two more come.
Alright, level 3 Brain Burster. I don't know what that spell does, but I'm just gonna take a wild guess and say it.
Cyberpsychosis?
Burst the brain.
Burst the brain.
Sean, are you still playing Cyberpunk?
I am.
Someone pointed out something that I agree with. I don't like it's a false sense of urgency that the main quest gives you.
Yeah.
Like, it really, really wants you to, it seems like it wants you to finish it quick. And so you end up I ended up not doing a lot of the side stuff.
Well, I've done almost no side stuff because I'm waiting for that lull point in the campaign where you don't feel like, holy shit, if I don't go address this right now, there's major consequences.
It will never come.
So I think that's a massive flaw in the game, because they want you to explore all this content. They clearly made a map the size of fucking Manhattan, and yet you feel like you shouldn't or can't go explore any of it because you've got more pressing shit.
Yeah. I think that's an artifact of earlier development. Like, I think Night City was always going to be big, but the urgency of the quest, like... I have no way to prove this, but I'm pretty sure once they signed Keanu, a lot of things changed with the way that game got played. That stuff where you get montaged and like yada yada past like your first 6 months in Night City or whatever.
Yeah.
I am almost certain that was originally stuff you played through. It was like the first quarter of the game. Especially because if you look at those cutscenes, they all look like. I don't know, they seem to be really high quality.
Well, especially the one where, like, you and Jackie are in the club, like, dancing and shit like that. Like, that looked like that had a whole backstory to it and shit like that, but then they just kind of, like, yada yada through that whole fucking thing.
Yeah, I think the idea was that, so, one thing they did mention was that people who bought The Witcher, lots of people bought and played The Witcher, but very few people finished the main quest. Like, the main story. Because it's a long fucking game. Like, it's...
Wow. I I completionist ran The Witcher.
Oh yeah, but like, you, and this is like, once you decide you want all the money, this is like the problem you run into. Do you want a game that casuals will be like, okay, I'm satisfied with this? Or do you want a game that your core fans are like, yes, I will completionist everything. I will sit here with my poop sock and my piss jug and my Doritos and not leave my computer until it's done. Like, you have to balance that if you want to expand outside of your core fan base. And Fallout did it very poorly. Fallout 4 is a shooter that happens to take place in Fallout, but by them neutering the dialogue by making it fully voiced, and then the basically getting rid of the leveling system, replacing it with nothing but perks, really kind of killed the RPG feel for it. In my opinion, for all it's worth. So, that game now appeals to a much wider audience. Like, my wife loves it. She hates New Vegas because it's too RPG-like.
I don't mind Fallout 4 so much, but I did absolutely love New Vegas.
I mean, Microsoft owns them both so maybe we'll get...
And to be fair, I have beaten the story in New Vegas, but I have not beaten the story in Fallout 4.
Fallout 4 was not a very satisfying story to beat.
I get to the end where I have to make a decision, and I'm just like, nah, let's just go do side quests.
Who stole my fucking son? Start shooting people. That right. Just explained all of Fallout 4.
Yep.
Basically. All right, Silver Pinnacle, you done goofed.
Whatever happened to those people? The you done goofed guy. He's like, I'm gonna call the internet police on you. Because, like, people were talking shit to his daughter and she was crying.
Oh, I don't remember.
I don't remember this.
Yeah, so you done goofed.
Vaguely familiar.
Is an old meme. Not quite Deep Magics of the Internet, but it's old. And you can still find it. The video is still on YouTube, I think. Where this chick was, like, doing just a vlog. And, you know, the internet being the internet, people will talk shit to her. And she... being a kid and not really, you know, getting how to deal with trolls, didn't just ignore them, and her dad got real, real mad and started, like, yelling at the camera, like, came in her room, started, oh, I'm gonna die, I'm gonna die, I'm gonna die, oh no, I'm falling, now I'm stuck.
Yeah, I don't remember that part.
Maybe I won't die?
Sure.
hey, they didn't die, wow, okay. So, basically, I was like, I skipped a lot of the map, and I don't think I was supposed to. But so this chick was sitting there crying, her dad comes in, he gets all pissy, and he's like, you done goofed, I'm gonna call the internet police on you, I'm gonna back trace your IP. Like, it's like, I can understand why he's mad, but. I can also understand why the internet memed him. Ash
in
the soil and a gun in my
hands. Let's go. In your own words, good sir, you done goofed.
Basically.
I can just hear Alucard. You done goofed.
How in the blood-soaked Protestant hell did you do that? Fuck you, that now.
Can I ever get a new ship?
No.
The ship's dumb.
This is your ship. There may like it, but this one is yours.
I have petition for a new ship?
Yeah, ain't happening. Not only is this no longer canon, I'm pretty sure Disney's not going to really renew the license in 2023. So, you definitely are not getting a new ship.
I demand a formal protest.
Denied.
Well, you can
I
go...
demand an informal protest. Denied.
You can go to change.org and make a petition that no one cares about and pretend like you did something important.
problem, baby.
Sweet bubbles. I don't think so.
Put one on the clone platform and see if it gives you a cost. That'd be the only thing I could recommend.
I figured I'd ask before we go all the way over there.
Oh.
Alright, make me look good.
Oh, yeah.
So again.
Oh, mess. You're for money.
Say it again. Only do so much. I'm probably gonna lose Iron Rock in this process.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
Well, these dwarves from the north are pushing down, and I can't destroy these dwarves behind me, so I'm probably just gonna recede into the mountains, because then I've got my back into a wall and no one can actually attack me anymore.
Fucking carpetbagging Yankee dwarves.
Take these dwarves out, then go back and reclaim my homelands. That's probably gonna be what I have to do.
Dwarves.
Not thrilled about it, but... And I just murdered another rat. There you go.
I had a D&D question for you, Sean.
Shoot.
The various ranks they talk about in Goblin Slayer, where they're like, oh yeah, Priestess just got her Obsidian rank.
Yep.
I've never played a D&D campaign where these were a thing.
Oh.
Every D&D campaign uses an Adventurers Guild rank system, but people debate heavily what the official rank system is. In my campaigns, it goes bronzes to iron rank to steel rank, and then after that it goes copper, silver, gold, platinum, and then after that it goes into the ascendant ranks, which are mithril, adamantine, and star steel.
Okay, so what's obsidian then?
Obsidian's in the other system, and it goes bronze, silver, obsidian, mithril, platinum. I can't remember what the last three are.
Because the paladins are saying there in the Adventurers Guild, talking about how Goblin Slayer is a silver rank that just kills goblins. Like it's
he's lower on the rank than Priestess is right now, because he doesn't take any other quests besides Goblin Slaying quests. And then later on, he does increase in rank into the actual anime, but it's like they don't make that very explicit. The whole rank thing is kind of. Yada yada.
Oh, lower in rank than the Priestess? I thought he was like they were saying he's a silver rank.
So it was high.
Goblin slaying quest. So it was
right.
Like...
Yeah, that's how I interpreted it too.
Yeah.
So like, what rank are those paladins? Are they also silver rank? Because it makes it seem like they're super high.
The witch lady, the one with the boobs of holding, and the guy who uses the spear, they're like top tier. They're like, because she's creating ninth level scrolls, right? She's creating scrolls.
Ninth level squirrels, sir.
Yeah, you know what
squirrels,
I mean.
Squirrels. I don't give a fuck.
I made a magic squirrel out of spite.
Yeah, so it's one of those things where it's like they're top rank. They're in. They're the shit.
I'm receiving the transmission. Give me a second to fine tune the frequency.
Jack, the campaign I've been playing with. Preston and his roommates, Orlando and Sergio, we're in the Adventurers Guild, essentially, in Sean's campaigns.
Wait a second, you're playing a campaign and we quit playing our other campaign?
No, we do the one-shots whenever I'm home in Texas.
Oh, okay. I was going to say,
I say
just one chicken pick in minute, sir. You owe us a campaign. So they're running out on us for education and school.
The Four Horsemen. I still have all my notes and everything.
You wouldn't believe what it I've been pestering Sean to start this back up forever.
We'll have a distinct problem considering a major member of your party is no longer even in the kingdom.
Replace him with somebody else.
You know, just fucking melon baller him out of the campaign.
Listen, I just played a game that had like a $1 billion budget and the yada 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 half the story. We just got done talking about it. If they could do it, we can do it.
Oh, that game that kind of flopped?
Actually, it's pretty good. People talk a lot of shit about it because it is poorly optimized, but if you just brute force it by having the best graphics card on the market, it works really well. Like, I'm sure this runs poorly if you need to worry about optimizations, but I have a 3080, so...
I heard from a lot of people that Cyberpunk 2077 was all hyped, and it wasn't really...
Okay, so there are two schools of thought on this. There are the people who had reasonable expectations based on CDPR's previous games, the source material, what CDPR said you're going to get, and there are people who live in Never Never Land, who... Like, oh, cool, I'm going to be like a cyberpunk... I'm going to be a noodle chef that goes fishing in his free time. Like, I'm real sure they didn't say we were ever going to get that game. Like, but open world. Like, that's not what open world means. And those people were severely disappointed because they got a game that was never going to exist, that they were ever told was going to exist, and was reality only in their minds, their collective hive mind.
I'd say there's a happy medium between those extremists who are like, yeah, I want to be a fucking cobbler in Cyberpunk, like, and the people who are expecting a little more dynamic gameplay than what they've already gotten. Like,
I think that's where a lot of people exist. Like,
a little more interaction with all the different factions would have been nice. A little bit more customization would have been nice. Stuff that they didn't explicitly say was going to be in the game, but was definitely heavily hinted at, that wouldn't be a stretch of logic. Like, I agree there are the extremists who were like, oh, I wanted to be able to have a waifu that was like a 9-foot-tall steel gorilla. Like there are the really crazy out there people, but there's also the people like me that were like, man, I would have liked my neon tattoos and like to be able to be tight with the moxies and shit. Like,
so I think the reason I'm not disappointed is because for the last, I don't know, since 2016, have been like immersed in every way that I could find in all things Cyberpunk, from the tabletop to whatever news CDPR was putting out about the game. And so, like, when they said, "Oh yeah, you're a solo who is kind of new to Night City, and you're just trying to make your name for yourself," like, I knew exactly what they meant. Like, you're a solo. You're not going to align with any faction, because once you just start picking sides, work dries up real quick. So, like, you don't align with anyone, you just go to whoever's paying the most. Like, I never expected to be able to align with the factions. What I think was misleading a bit is they said, we want to, with The Witcher, Geralt is such an established character that we couldn't deviate very far from what he is and who he is and how he does things. But with V, it's kind of, you know, you do your own thing. And you can, to a degree. You can play the game, I think, without killing anybody. You can murder everyone you see. Like, there's, and everything in between. But there is not nearly the ability to, like, well, maybe I don't want to be a solo. Maybe I want to be a fixer. Maybe I want to be a moxie. Things like that.
Yeah, because it wouldn't have been too much of a stretch from where the game currently is to allow more, like, faction-based gameplay. Like, how they've got the fixers that, like, give you quests for everything like that. There should be one or, like, a few for each guild. And, like, a reputation system. Like, if you get really tight... And you could even be tight with multiple factions unless they are, like, conflicting with each other. But, like, reputation's handled in a lot of MMOs and open-world games. Wouldn't have been, like... a crazy stretch for them to have thrown into Cyberpunk, but they kind of did leave that, like, out, and it's like you're kind of tied in with
how exactly.
Well, I can't say too much without spoilers, but you're tied in with who you're tied in with, and you don't really go anywhere else besides with who you're tied in with. You know what I mean?
Yeah, and thematically that makes sense for the genre. Like, did you read like Neuromancer or Snow Crash or any of that?
No.
Yeah, so it's not a genre where you save the world and make friends with everybody. If you're lucky, you, like, so there's no love stories. Love stories always end badly for some way. If you do save anyone, it's yourself and maybe someone you're close to. But otherwise, you don't save the world. In fact, the world goes on basically the way it was before you got involved in any of this stuff. And that's just, and the game does that very well.
Well, even in that case, we're also talking about them trying to adapt the game to a broader audience, and I feel like they would have caught more fish and still stayed true to the genre if they allowed you that dynamic reasoning. I'm not saying flowery ending, you know, everything turns out fine, all the corporations are taken down and everybody's friends, but I'm like, you know, you can get real tight with a click and get your version of victory out of the game.
Yeah, and they may yet add that. They're also approaching Cyberpunk as a...
quick sidetrack. Muffins, what the fuck is going on?
I was waiting for a lull in the conversation. Bloody Spears? Friends? Not friends?
Undetermined. We haven't had any interaction with them. They're stuck between us and the dwarves and probably shitting themselves, so...
Alright, I'll leave them be for now, because I have dwarves to deal with.
Yeah, I've got dwarves out the ass right now, so...
That is where they come out of. Yeah, so, like, they have said they're going to have at least as much DLC paid and free as The Witcher got, and The Witcher had a fuck ton of it. So, and they've also said that, this isn't the last Cyberpunk game, it's the first one they're making. They want to turn this into a, for them, it's a very big, long, expansive, like, this is going to, like, Ubisoft has, like, you know, Assassin's Creed and all that, like they, like everyone knows, oh, it's a Ubisoft game. Cyberpunk's going to, what they want Cyberpunk to be that for CDPR. Like this is their big Highline series that everyone associates with them. And so we're probably going to,
they're going to get the support to do that.
How?
Well, off of the response that they've just received for 2077.
They sold 13 million copies in a week.
Okay, Jack, yes, let's go ahead and pretend there's no controversy over 2077. Okay, let's go ahead and take a dip into Fantasyland now.
hey, you're
fucking go ahead and use the skewed numbers to make your point, like, not everyone on the fucking market's been shitting on this game for a fucking month now.
You sound a little spicy, man. I'm not trying to have a fight here.
No, but I'm saying, like, you can't throw out and pretend like nothing's been wrong and expect to still have a constructive conversation.
Yeah,
like,
but the memory span of the internet's like shorter than a goldfish. And what we have seen is what I didn't necessarily think it would take this long, but we are starting to see articles. Okay, everyone's done bitching about the game, and now they're talking about how, wow, this is actually a pretty good solid story, and you're starting to see a lot of people get past the fact that they're aggrieved for whatever reason, some of them legit, some of them not, and just talking about how the game itself rather than how broken it was at launch. So I think you gotta give it time. They may have lost some goodwill, but I think they'll gain it back.
Isn't it still broken?
No, they've been patching the shit out of it. Well, let me walk that back a minute. Depending on what you're playing on, it's not broken. And it also depends on your expectations.
All I heard from the game was, there was a fuck ton of technical issues.
It depends on what you're playing on. It really does. If you're playing on PC,
yeah,
they patched most of the issues very relatively quickly. If you're playing on console, I haven't played for over a week though, because I beat the main story, so I was going. Only play it on Twitch now, but I missed my slot last night because I felt like I was...
How long did it take you to beat the main story?
50 hours. And I didn't completion it. Like, well, I didn't, like, rampage through it. I took time to do other stuff, but I also didn't, like... So it's... You can do it in 40 hours, I think, is what they said.
I don't know. I've played The Witcher all the way through, and that's kind of what I'm expecting in this case.
I would say this
set in Night City.
The story is of the same caliber.
That's fine. I think as long as we're talking about a good story like that, then I'll do that.
Grand Theft Auto's a longer storyline than this?
Grand Theft Auto's the pilot.
Grand Theft Auto
is not fun, but
GTA 5 barely has a story. Well, you used to, back before they figured out that MTX is a fucking money printer. After they figured that out, they just stopped making everything and only focused on microtransactions, which is a road that CD has said they want to go down, because the online mode that comes out in 2021 is supposed to have a lot of... It's basically Grand Theft Auto Online. What they have described it as sounds a lot like Grand Theft Auto Online, but first person.
They stopped doing shit with Grand Theft Auto even though they just released like a big update.
Yeah, what I mean is they stopped all the story content. You can still buy a bunch of stuff, but you have to do it online. It's not single player. The story is very loose. It's not like they used to do.
Oh, I mean, I thought when the game came out, boom, that's the story.
No, like older Grand Theft Auto games, you would get like if you had expansion, you would get expansion packs for it.
Yeah.
And they would come out, and you'd get a new game like every 3 years or so. Since Grand Theft Auto 5 came out and shark cards became a thing, they basically stopped making new games. It is, if you look at a timeline of Rockstar's games, they haven't gone this long between series ever. Between games and between series. Like, shark cards and MTX basically killed their desire to make new content.
Sean, I have a beef with you.
Oh, what is the beef?
Those stupid gits have gone and plundered stuff from the boss, what's his name up there? We're not meant to do that, we made a pact and everything. What we gonna do? Either make him take it back or sod it.
God, why are they all cockney? That's what I want to know.
Cockney, I'm uncultured.
Why don't they sound like they're from Mississippi?
What is the consequences for each?
Diplomats.
Oh, fuck it. I'm not going to start a war with you, so it doesn't matter. Yeah, take the one that's better for you, even if it tanks our reputation. I don't give a fuck.
It doesn't do anything. The only effect is diplomatic relations.
Oh, then yeah, do whatever. It doesn't matter.
God, this thing looks like a vagina with legs and spikes.
Sorry?
This creature in front of me that's getting mad that I'm standing so close to it. It seriously looks like a spiky mouth vagina with legs. And eyes.
Okay.
It does! We'll just call that eye up there the clit. Alright, back to what I was doing.
Just get a... I'm gonna go get a drink.
But no, so there's currently a comic series out that was a limited run four issues. They have an anime coming out to Netflix next year. They have Cyberpunk Online, the online module for 70s. Well, not module. They say it shouldn't be thought of as a module, but it's its own separate game coming out in 21. And then I'm guessing we'll get another game after that. Like, they've got the rights to a lot more content. And Artalsorian hasn't publicly at least said anything about not wanting to work with them in the future. So I expect we'll get more. I also expect that they won't say shit about what's in the game, and they're going to product test the bejesus out of it before it comes out. And you're not wrong, Sean, that they have lost a lot of goodwill, but I think it's going to be pretty easy for them to earn it back.
I don't doubt that if handled properly, they could squeeze more games out of it, but it's certainly... It would definitely be misrepresenting how this release has gone to say, oh, they sold 13 million copies, they're doing absolutely fine, the community's thrilled. It's like, they've been very vocal about the fact that they're not. Like,
well, yeah. What I mean by that, though, is that they've paid for the development of the game, basically. And they can make more. It's not like the CD's going to go under, even with returns.
Not by any means.
The game is a financial success, and since they are a publicly traded company, in a lot of ways, unfortunately, that's what matters. It was a financially successful game. Like, I hate that that's the case.
Because it was their first one, and a lot of people bought this out of hype alone, we also have to throw that onto the train here. Because the other premise is that there was just a shitload of there was 13 million super loyal Cyberpunk fans out there, and everyone who bought it was as into the genre as you are, and factually, that's not the case.
Right. it would be interesting to find out how many Miis there are. Because honestly, they could have like released a flip phone game, and I would have been like, this is the greatest game of all time.
Right.
Game of the year, game of the decade, game of the century. But a lot of people obviously wouldn't be like that. Like, most sane people.
I don't know. I'm new to the cyberpunk genre. I've enjoyed the prologue I've played. And, granted, yes, I am running a 3080, right. So I don't have any of the technical issues.
Oh, dude, Muffins, I've been begging Sean to do a Cyberpunk campaign, or at least a one-shot, for a year. Man, I would...
All right.
And as well as...
I feel like this is one of those cases where you get a little bit of bad press for something, and then the shit just sort of piles up because people hear something negative about it, and then they're expecting more negative shit.
And the way news works anymore, it's all clickbait. And this game is clickbait well, for the first month, it was clickbait the game. Like,
whoa, Sean.
All the news about it was clickbait. So.
That was battle.
That was a big challenge.
Alright, just a second, guys, I'll be right back.
I'm gonna have to give up on these fucking dwarves.
So you made it back. You did good work out there. All the data's intact. Did Sanju tell you those computers had a list of Imperial collaborators? You helped us expose traitors.
Does this prove that I'm on your side?
Proof doesn't exist in this business. You know that. But you're doing all right. And I need your skills for a special job. I don't have anyone else who can handle it.
Sounds like you're starting to rely on me.
If that's what it sounds like, then that's what it sounds like. You know all about the way the Empire and the Republic have been using our planet as a battleground. Pretty obvious stuff. Normally, the Republic doesn't bother us. They've got other worries. But I need someone to get inside the main Republic base.
It won't be simple, but you've come to the right person.
Good attitude. I need you to make a drop to one of our friends in the Republic ranks. Get past the guards, get inside and make the delivery. That's it.
I guess I'll just have to trust you.
Here's the package and the coordinates of your target. He'll know what to do once you make the delivery. We're clearing out this safe house, so I'll contact you once we've settled somewhere else. And be careful at the base.
I never really understood that Balmora was like Vietnam. Like it's a proxy battlefield.
Believe me, I can handle a few soldiers.
See you in a while. If you make it back alive, I can promise we'll be working together a lot.
We'll talk soon. Watch yourself.
All right, I'm back. You know, Sean, I would actually I think I would enjoy DMing a game of Cyberpunk, but I just don't know how. Like, can you coach me in the ways of DMing?
I mean, kind of, but I also don't know how to DM a game of Cyberpunk. Like, DM a game of D&D, sure, but, like, I don't know what the crossover between those two would be.
I guess, so I have a lot of lore and world knowledge, but I just don't know what a DM does in general, because I've never done it, you know?
I mean, the general concept is... Oh, shit, I'm about to lose these fucking books. The general concept is that you set, like, an end goal, a big bad guy, and challenges along the way for them to intersect, and you kind of lay it out so that way they're kind of trying to solve a puzzle. Like, they have to go talk to all the right people, interact with all the right assets, and, like, do the right stuff in order for them to actually get a hold of the storyline. Wow, I just got absolutely wiped out.
Oh.
This is the end of the campaign for me.
Oh, wow.
Yep.
Sean, have you done the Voodoo Boys yet?
I have not.
Okay. After you're done with them, I'm going to share something with you about that. Some knowledge. But I can't tell you what I'm going to tell you without it being a big spoiler, so you're just going to have to wait till you do the Voodoo Boys.
Yeah, Muffins, I'm basically dead in the water now.
Uh-oh.
I can rebuild, but it's gonna be tough.
I mean, you're playing an army of sentient fungus. We just need to let you be in a dark room that's of, like, mild humidity, and it'll all be alright.
Yeah.
Should I attack these rats up here? I kinda need these two cities.
Yeah, go ahead. I have a feeling we're not going to win this campaign, to be honest. I thought I was doing fine up until I saw the fucking High Elf units, and I don't know why, but they're like 30 of my men is one of theirs. I don't know why. I would need to field like 6 armies, and
oh, shit.
On an economy basis, I can't do that.
Damn it. I fell off the side of a ledge. Ah, crap, I need to go back there and get my shit repaired.
products only as intended.
Well,
GG. Yeah, this campaign might be over. You've got your backup army, I've got my backup army, but now we're pretty bad ways.
Be well.
I'm one turn away from a wah.
Same.
But I don't know if that's gonna save me.
Do you require medical attention?
Yeah, I'm pretty genuinely fucked here.
Be well.
You said you wanted to talk.
What? Oh, yeah, sorry. No idea what I was gonna say. Been distracted. Thinking about home.
We don't spend a lot of time in comfortable surroundings.
Said I was thinking. Didn't say I missed it. Life was miserable on Ratatak. Backwards people living in caves. Big on tribal blood feuds. Almost got stoned to death when I was 12. That's when I knew I had to get out.
So how'd you get off-world?
I hitched a ride on a spice trafficker ship. Figured the big, civilized galaxy would have a place for me. I thought I was gonna get accepted. I had to get tough.
You don't have to be tough. I'm here for you. Anything you need.
Can you stop for 1 minute? I tried to tell you something and you're all over me. Just forget I said anything.
Like one of our friend chat groups on GroupMe, and she said Doc's stuff is getting old, and I just put a picture of like bitmoji thingy or emoji of a granny, and now she's calling me Nana, Grammy, Granny. Like, I was telling Trav this morning that like when I was 31, I was like, oh, okay, that's close enough to 30. I'm not old yet. And then now I'm 32, and I'm like, I'm over the edge. It's just downhill.
I hate to break it to you, but 35 exists.
Yeah. 35 is just like fucking boomer.
Not quite. Though I do take naps now.
I guess we're at war with the Norska now.
Time to murder.
Time to murder.
Here I go, yeah. Killing again.
Genuinely didn't think I'd be able to survive my shenanigans long enough to make it to 25. Then made it to 25, and now I'm at 27, and I'm going at 30, and I'm like, holy shit, I keep just... I don't know what I keep doing, but I just keep doing stuff that keeps working. Before I know it, I'll be crawling up on 35.
I'm telling you, man, naps become a requirement of life.
Yikes.
Oh no, it's good, man, it's good.
I take naps now.
You're just getting ahead of yourself, Trav. You're getting practice in early.
My wife's always taking a lot of naps, and I don't. And I never understood, like, why are you just sleep at night? Sleep more at night. That's all you need to do. And now I'm like, oh god, it is nap time, isn't it? Okay, I'm going back to bed.
Trav, I feel like you're not really napping, you're just like getting over your food coma from eating so bad.
Things can be two things at once, alright?
Yeah.
Well,
I will say the art direction for this game is solid. Like, they managed to make this stuff look like vastly older versions of their equivalents in the primary trilogy and all that. Like, tech progress is slow in Star Wars. Like, we've had hyperspace travel for thousands of years, tens of thousands of years. And robots and blasters and shit. It's just... So you end up with a slow, almost plateau. You're increasing at a decreasing rate of advancement. So, like, this stuff looks sufficiently old, like a sufficiently older version of what it should be. And the fast travel system is a real treat. Like, it just is. Because you still have to, like, watch your shuttle or whatever go through the world. And the game's awfully pretty. Well, it looks like the house, voted to, amend the stimulus bill to include $2,000 checks. Trump's already supported it, so it's up to the Senate. We might be getting a good payday, guys.
Well, you will. I won't.
You'll still get $2,000, won't you? Why not? Is someone else claiming you on their taxes?
No. Just because I could potentially in some situation be claimed on taxes.
So
if I am, just that I could.
That's so. I'm by no means a tax lawyer, and I'm not like super qualified to give you advice on this topic. However, I would investigate it because if you didn't get it during the year, there's a provision that allows you to get the stimulus as a tax credit on your tax return for 2020.
How old are you, my friends?
25.
You should be able to get it, man. You should have gotten it, I think.
No, I think it's through your 25th you could be claimed by your parents, right? Or is it at your 25th birthday?
Something like that.
It's when you turn 25, you can no longer be claimed.
I thought it was through your 20th. Okay.
No, you can claim it.
I just went through it, or like with my dad, not last year, but the year before.
There is some paperwork you can fill out to basically have it like, yes, I'm an independent person, I'm no longer claimed. And I think when you like file your taxes, all you have to do is check that, like, yeah, no one claims me.
I got the last stimulus check, but isn't for this one only for people who make less than $5,000 a year?
Did you get claimed by your parents last year?
No, it's because I'm a college student, and I guess under like almost whatever.
But you have a W-2.
Everybody else in my lab got it, and they're all college students.
Yeah, man, I think you missed out. I think you're supposed to get that.
I think you need to go online, because you can still request it. It's just, it got direct deposited to you if you did file.
Oh, no, like, I went through every avenue, and it, I just straight up didn't qualify, because, they fucked me.
Don't they know there's a line? They can't just jump ahead of a line to fuck muffins.
I mean, I don't know why anyone...
That makes me think something was done wrong.
Yeah.
I mean, I wouldn't put it past that, but, like... What am I gonna do? Hire a lawyer? So, like...
No, but there's probably, like, a form or something you could fill out to get it. It's run by the government. There is absolutely a form that can fix all of your problems. Yep. That is the basis of government. There's some paperwork somewhere. And even if it takes an hour, like, I mean...
It's worth it.
That'll be the most well-paid hour maybe of your entire life. Especially if they bump up to 2,000, because then you're looking at the one from March and this one.
But I also repeat... Doesn't it, like, Don't want like you and me not get it, Jack, because it's only for people who make less than $75,000 a year.
No. So they based it on 2019's tax records, which I was still a college hire and had not gotten to that. I hadn't maxed it out yet, but I'm also married, so the cap is 150 grand for me.
And we did it. So I simply will not get it.
You still get some, or you should get some, because it decreases. It's on a sliding scale. Like for every $1,000 over to $75,000, it decreases by X amount. To where basically, if you between $75,000 and $100,000, anything under $100,000, you should get something. Like my buddy who works at Cisco, he's like, "Oh yeah, I didn't even look into it. There's no way I'm getting it." But I know some other people who are, you know, young single guys like you that are in that sliding threshold area, that they could get something. I mean, free money, it's always worth looking into.
I guess it's worth looking again, but like when all the stimulus was originally going around, like one, I had definitely filled out a tax return, and I know because I had gotten my tax return back. And then two, every damn time I would look at the stimulus, they rolled it out really
fucking.
Yeah,
funny. But I think it was filing from 2019, though.
Which I also did.
Okay.
Like, there was no... Well, okay. It was really fucky because it wouldn't tell you, like, you didn't qualify. It would just say there's no information available. And that wasn't because they didn't have it, but then you look further and it says, oh, if you didn't qualify, or if there's no information available, then that means you didn't qualify. It's just like they lumped everyone in the same camp, despite not being.
What did the Crooked Moons want?
Just non-aggression.
Did you accept?
They can rob my stomach right now. I can't afford a fight.
One of the orc tech tree options is Healy mushrooms. Will you eat mushrooms that heal you?
Cannibalism. Are you just eating your brethren?
Probably.
Alright, make me look good.
Asher's want a non-aggressive pack, you've got one. Mostly because I have no force to be denying people right now.
Man, since I started doing the streaming thing, I need to install a second set of shelves in this room that are behind me. Because right now I have all like my nerd shit on shelves above my monitor. But no one in the stream can see it.
No one knows.
No one will know how big of a nerd I am. That's a problem. I know. Oh, no. Well, if they start talking to me for 2 minutes, they'll figure it out pretty soon. Like, so, how about those sports teams? Like, yes, sports teams.
That's sports ball. They made score point.
They did. They got the ball to the thing. And did so efficiently.
And according to pending changes to economic stimulus relief legislation, all IRS activities related to economic stimulus checks is shut down at the moment. So not only am I not going to potentially look into this, but no one is.
So what I would recommend, for whatever my recommendation is worth, because you can get it on your taxes, I would say when you do your 2020 taxes, if it might be worth like going to H&R Block and asking them about it. Normally I'm not a fan of having someone pay to do their taxes because it's so simple to do on your own. But in this case, I think it might be worth the extra money to do so. Like, I would explain your situation and be like, can you guys, if, you know, I pay you to do my taxes, can you help me figure out if I rate this and how to get it? And then, you know, if they say yes, then it might be worth having them do it.
Here's what you do. You walk in, put your dick on the table, says, I'm the one true git, give me my money, then walk out.
It's not gonna suck itself, ladies. Only the Sunday edition can do that.
What'd you say, Larry?
And gentlemen.
And gentlemen. It's 2020, Jack. We gotta be inclusive.
True, true, true. I'm often accidentally not as progressive as I believe I am most of the time. I wasn't purposely excluding gentlemen. I was pretty sure Muffins is in the dudes, but we never really talked about it. Yeah, you know, I was assuming a lot there.
You know what they say when you assume, Jack? You make an ass out of yourself.
You you make a reasonable guess based on your knowledge about the situation?
Yeah, that's how the saying goes.
What did you say, Lyra?
Yes,
snails on his dick. He doesn't care what the lady looks like as long as she got them snails.
Oh, no lady, just snails.
Just snails? Well, snail ladies?
Just imagine that conversation. Hey girl, I noticed you across the bar and I like your style. I couldn't help but notice that you got all these snails on you. Like,
first of all, I've got so many questions about what kind of bar you're in where there's just women with snails.
Like I said, like you said before, Jack, me and you run in different circles. Okay? Like,
we do.
Gentlemen with snails.
Or gentlemen. Or people who don't necessarily align in non-binary individuals who have an affinity for sexual snails.
Where's this dance club at?
Right? I feel like I just RNG'd a dance club into existence.
Hi, welcome to the Slithering Trail. We're a non-binary dance club for people who have snail fetishes. Can I get you a table? And a box of snails.
The only rule is that no one's allowed to have salt on the premise.
No salt allowed.
What about outside of the BDSM dungeon?
I think that's a different club.
Yeah, different club for that one.
Please tell me you didn't deliver the package to the Republic base yet.
What's going on, Sanju?
That package you're carrying is for Graystar, the terror cell leader. Graystar's the man inside the Republic base. Kemish wants to extract him, and you've been sent to help.
If you're right, then Graystar is mine.
That's how it looks. The best I can tell,
Graystar has been secretly managing and supplying the Terra Cell while pretending to be a loyal Republic officer. It was the perfect cover. Well, until the Republic started to suspect. Now Graystar needs to escape before he's caught.
He's not going anywhere. I can promise that.
Well, maybe, but there's something else. Your package contains instructions and maps leading to a safe house. But we could change those instructions. Send Graystar into a trap. Once we have Graystar, we could make him give up his security protocols. We could send out orders to the cell using his name.
That's never going to work.
I know how Kimish and her people think. If we capture Graystar and learn what he knows, I can forge convincing orders. Chief Reynolds has been looking for a way to turn the terrorists against the Republic for ages. We can make it work.
What exactly do you need?
I'm sending you rendezvous coordinates. If you want to do this thing, tell Graystar to meet me there. I'll arrange the rest. If you don't send him my way, well, I guess you'll have to kill him.
You have anything else for me?
I don't know if I'll see you again. Depending on what happens with Graystar, I may have to go into hiding for a while. But it's been an honor working with you. Sanju, out.
You guys been watching The Expanse?
I have not.
This might be the best season they've ever done.
Oh, did you say it's too hard to watch?
Yeah.
Why is it hard to watch?
It's just so complicated. It's hard to pay attention.
Oh,
We've tried watching the show like twice, and every time it's just like...
How, Did you start at the beginning?
Yes.
Okay.
No, start at the end.
I don't know what the show is.
It's on Amazon Prime.
It's a
sci-fi thing.
It's a sci-fi series that started as a book series that Jeff Bezos bought the rights to after Sci-Fi Channel canceled it. It wasn't canceled because it was like bad. It was that Sci-Fi's deal for it was so goddamn bad. Like, if TV worked the way it did 10 years ago, they would have made tons of money. But they didn't get any royalty checks for anything that wasn't people watching it on the premiere night. The show does amazingly well in streaming and with people buy the seasons. But not a lot of people, like, schedule their time around TV shows anymore. So Sci-Fi just wasn't making any money, and it cost a ton to produce. So Amazon bought it because Jeff Bezos likes it, and... now he funds it all.
It's a very complicated story here.
Not terribly. George R. R. Martin has called it Game of Thrones in space. It does have that kind of huge world kind of aspect to it, where there's a lot of shit going on. The books are fantastic. And I'm a big fan of the show. Baby.
Per voli drafa ut potamina. Menufitan fine milman murio matu miten. Eru eleflara garo. Is haborges yem ze vaxa inatro. Bome finadre.
How did you know I was coming?
Imar ne am pasa gefur hog bruor. Egarus plot as vista bokar pina, renuimar stro deber kulpukuni.
Can't you at least tell me what you're doing here?
Nawi ura triste umormiki. Omeo, umrus nomin, muslon fatei. Ah, scoribo for remitia dosium,
There's been a change of plans. You're gonna rendezvous with one of our people at these coordinates. When you get to the rendezvous, give them my regards.
Back.
Welcome back.
The thing that's neat about them, like if you get into the books, they're sci-fi by definition, but that doesn't control the story so much. Like the first book is a hard-boiled detective novel, just happens to take place on an asteroid. Book four is a western. It's absolutely a western. You have the frontier town run by a mining collective. The sheriff that's in the pocket, the bad guy sheriff that's in the pocket of the industrial giant that wants to, you know, take all the mining rights away from the miners. You have the federal lawman coming in to mediate. Like it's 100% a western. It just takes place on a planet that's not Earth. The others run the gamut from Tom Clancy to a little bit of John Grisham. None of them are purely science fiction. They're all written in a form that isn't that, which makes it more compelling than just sci-fi nonsense. There is some space magic, but there's very little of it. Like, overall, it's just a really good book, set of books and a fantastic TV show. And the TV show is very accurate to the books, as much as you could be. So, if you guys got time, and you're looking for something new, highly recommend giving it a shot.
I highly recommend not giving it a shot.
I will say, it takes a little bit getting into it, because it is a very big...
Shit, what is this? Are they... Is this my garrison? Yeah. Fuck.
There is kind of a lot going on in the story, and you get thrust into it, but once you figure out what's going on, it becomes amazing.
I'm also, like, one of those people, like, when I watch television, I like to, like, do other things at the same time, and that's a show you can't do other things. You have to pay
attention. Oh, not at all. Yeah, yeah, you have to watch it.
And, I don't know, I just didn't find it entertaining enough to watch it.
I got to meet a few of the cast members a couple years ago, and the woman that plays, she plays a space marine. She does such a good job of portraying a marine on the show, like a convincing enough for me, and I was in the Marine Corps, but like in real life, she's kind of, at least at the convention, kind of meek, kind of not, I don't know, not a big personality. It was kind of interesting to meet her in real life. Like, you're not at all like your character. At least this room full of nerdy strangers who want to pay to get your autograph. I will say I am severely miffed that one of the main cast turned out to be a fucking skeezy ass rapist. Well, he's getting written out of the show. And the thing that sucks is that out of the cast members, he probably had the best, like, fan engagement online. He was like the hype man for the community. And it turns out he likes to use his influence to sexually assault fans. Yeah, it was fucking...
Are you in raiding stance in your own land?
He's an orc. What do you expect? There is no muffins. There are only Daka.
There is only Wa. Muffins. Alright, I think Muffins died.
Oh, I'm here. I've been... Sorry, I've been trying to watch this, like... It's like a minute-long clip that Hollow posted, but I just couldn't hear over everyone.
Also, are you in raiding stance in your own land?
I'm in encampment stance.
I think that's a raiding encampment.
Oh. It is. Well, I still have to be in encampment to recruit units, though, don't I?
Not if you're on your own land.
Wait.
If it works like the other Total War games, like the types of units you can recruit change, but if you're in your own land, you can recruit as you're moving through it.
I mean, it wasn't letting me recruit before. I was just in movement, but... Also, it might be that I'm actually just outside my own... Oh, yeah, I am. I'm just outside of...
I'll have to drop here in a few minutes. I could go take care of a neighbor's cat.
Would your kitty get him pregnant?
No, it's a coworker of Sean and mine's. They're out of town. So when I'm out of town, he feeds my cats. When he's out of town, I go feed his and socialize with him and all that.
When you say take care of, do you mean... No. Take care of them, or do you mean like, you know, give them?
I feed them to this alien that crashed into my garage the other night. He's a weird furry little thing with a gonzo nose. He's endearing though.
Heard of this. Yeah.
It looks kind of muppety, but I guess all the species look like that.
No, I say no need to be racist here, Jack. You know.
He's an alien. I think I can say what I want about him.
Where's the term immigrant? Like, Jesus.
He is absolutely undocumented. We can verify that. I guess it makes me accessory to a felony for harboring him without telling the government.
All I'm saying is that that big old wall there, that's a red line. You cross that and that's hard time you're looking at.
In this case, by wall, we mean the moon.
It's a most heinous of crime. You crossed the line. Literally.
I mean, it's not like there are any, like, alligators or a moat. How was I supposed to know? They don't write it on the wall. It's like, it's a wall, so what? I mean... I actually listened to a really interesting dollop about Texas yesterday. It was about when they invented barbed wire. And Texas was a very different place before the invention of barbed wire. Like, they hated big landowners, they hated big companies, they referred to them as monopolists in a snide and mean way. And there were gangs of people who would go around clipping barbed wire because this ain't the way we do things, and you can't stop us from all sharing the land. I don't know what happened to this Texas, but this is a Texas I would live in. Willfully.
Go out to West Texas and you'll find it.
Really?
Yeah. You know when they talk about, like, hey, my neighbor could probably lend us a cup of sugar, I'll be back in an hour. Like, that's West Texas.
Yeah, but they vote for a lot of things that are not necessarily just that.
Never said they were smart.
They don't vote for friendly things. They just happen to be friendly people. And I'm the kind of guy that I need you to vote how you believe. Otherwise, I don't want to live near you on my own free will. All right, cutscenes. Be back.
I'd love to chat, but you should probably talk to the station chief first.
I expect a full report as soon as possible, station chief.
Of course. Of course, of course. As soon as things have calmed down... Ha! What have we here? If it isn't the Cypher himself come triumphantly to our doorstep, I was just telling our keeper about you.
Am I interrupting a meeting?
No, we were finishing up. Leonard, summarize the situation for Cypher 9.
You gave us quite a prize, Cypher. The Terra Cell under our control. Grey Star captured and replaced by Sanju Pine, of all people. I never dreamed we'd see such success, but Sanju has already begun sending orders, and the terrorists now unwittingly serve us.
Now that the cell's under your control, how do you intend to use it?
For the time being, Sanju will use the Grey Star persona to gather information and turn the terrorists against the Republic.
As time goes on, we may find other uses for the terrorists, but that's another discussion. The Balmoran cell is no longer a threat. The other cells in the Eagle's network will no longer receive fresh recruits and supplies from this world.
Any news on our primary target?
Progress is being made, but now is not the time for that discussion. Station Chief Reynolds will take matters from here. He'll run cleanup and forward any discoveries to headquarters. When you return to your ship, contact Watcher 2. She will brief you on all new developments and transfer credits to your discretionary accounts.
I'll be on my way shortly.
Good work once again, Cypher 9. Keep her out.
That man hides it well, but the strain's getting to him. Probably worried the Dark Council will skin him alive.
I'm not sure what you're talking about.
Make no mistake, I don't hold him responsible for what happened, but Darth Jadis was assassinated on his watch. Oh, but now's no time to discuss politics. You deserve a moment of celebration, and I have work to do.
It's been a pleasure doing business.
Indeed, my friend. Indeed.
Not bad, Agent. Not bad at all. You and me, we're going places.
Back. So the,
I just can't believe that these border princes are holding it still.
The inspiration for my legacy name in this game is from Donald Glover's Reddit username. It is Don Glover, but no space, which makes it very easily read as Don Glover. I did it on purpose. Have you watched Atlanta at all? The TV show? Have any of you guys watched it?
No.
It is.
I don't watch.
It is surprisingly good. Like, I didn't think I was going to be into it. But he writes it, he scores it. And he acts in it, and it's all amazingly well done. And him being from Stone Mountain certainly helps inform the his work, but it's pretty good. It's not very long either. I think there's only like 10 episodes per season. It's another one that if you got time, there's only 2 seasons out. So I think he's working on 3 and 4, but in between being Lando Calrissian, being Childish Gambino, and all the other shit he's got on his plate, it's just taking some time to get it done. But it's definitely quality. Actually, I haven't listened to any of his. Like, I've never heard a Childish Gambino song or album, to my knowledge. Hmm. Is it good?
Oh yeah, Childish
Gambino. What about This Is America?
Oh yeah, there's that one. I was wrong. I have heard that one. That's the only one. I think he wrote all the rap songs for, like the main character in Atlanta is the manager of his friend who is a rapper, and I think Donald Glover wrote all the rap songs for the TV show. Baby.
To bomb the Dominator and assassinate Darth Jadus. For what's coming, he's using the entire Terra network. But the messages we've intercepted are frustratingly vague. Just cryptic references to devices called Eradicators.
Any idea what an Eradicator is?
A weapon of some sort. But is it a laser? A virus? I don't know. Not much to be done at the moment. We need to focus on taking the Terra network apart. As you eliminate the larger cells, we can identify more terrorist activity centers. Eliminate enough, and the network will lose cohesion.
We'll get together once this is over, have a drink.
We'll have the opportunity. I'll do everything I can from here. It's been 4 days since I stepped outside the Citadel. But I'm in no hurry. I'll be in touch. Watch it out.
All right, and with that, I am done for now. I have to go feed a neighbor's cats. I have so much love for cats that my own 3 aren't enough, and I feed my neighbors when they're out of town. So, thank you all for watching. I appreciate it. If you're watching now or you're watching later, I hope everything's going all right for you, wherever you are in the world, kind of crazy times, and catch you next time.